I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to
move it.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to
move it.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to
move it. It's the world's oldest island, and it's had time to develop an astonishing range of landscapes. It's split in two by a spine of mountains that runs its entire length, and each side has its own character. On the western side lie huge forests, populated with strange bulging trees. Further south, an alien world, a parched and sandy wilderness. And on the eastern side, lush jungle, drenched in rain.
Itumbara varakilia umumi tazana Isanandritiala maitsumavana
Because the island has been cut off for so long, evolution has had a chance to produce a whole range of unique animals and plants. But now it seems that our planet is being transformed. Not by natural events, but by the actions of one species, mankind.
Of a rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, "How do you do?" They're really saying, "I love you." I see trees of green. Red roses, too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, bright, blessed days, dark, sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Quite simply wonderful. Many animals in Madagascar have some kind of fardi attached to them. I set out to find and film representative species of the whole animal kingdom in all its marvellous and wonderful variety. But in fact, it's a boa constrictor. And its nearest relatives are right on the other side in South America. It's one of the mysteries of Madagascar's fauna. This this is a chameleon, and Madagascar is the home of the chameleons. There are more different kinds of chameleons and more spectacular chameleons here than anywhere else in the world. They are, of course, very specialized lizards, but local people are very frightened of them. They move in this odd way, and they have these bizarre eyes, and they think that one glance from a chameleon is risking death, and a whole one would be disaster.
Its feet, with their adhesive pads on the end of the toes, were flattened so much that they seemed to melt into the bark, and the whole animal pressed itself so closely to the tree that it was almost indistinguishable from it.
A whole range of species live on the ground, many of which have only recently been discovered. Catches its food with its tongue.
Somehow or other, perhaps on a floating log, they reached the island of Madagascar. Here there were neither predators nor competitors, and here they diversified into an extraordinary range of species which now exploit every environment on the island. They are the lemurs. The most specialized of them is the golden bamboo lemur. It was discovered only recently, and it lives on a part of the bamboo that would be fatal to most other animals.
The Indri, the largest of lemurs. They live in families, a male, a female with her baby, and often a half-grown youngster.
Extremely long legs and very short arms make it impossible to run on all fours, so once again, it has to be jumping.
Many lemurs are nocturnal, and when darkness falls, a completely new cast of them appears. This is the smallest of all, little bigger than a mouse and called a mouse lemur.
You might think, at first sight, that these small creatures are baby hedgehogs. But they're not babies, for these are fully grown, and neither are they hedgehogs, although they seem to resemble them so closely. They are a strange, extremely primitive creature called a tenya, and they live nowhere else in the world but in Madagascar.
Birds are the most accomplished aeronauts the world has ever seen. They fly high and low, at great speed and very slowly,
and always with extraordinary precision and control. Calls in the forest also serve to keep animals apart. This is Madagascar. The female is the lead singer. The group's message proclaims its ownership of a territory and of the food it contains. Neighbours, when they hear it, defiantly respond with their own claims, so soon the forest is ringing with the calls of many groups.
Ours is truly a blue planet. Water covers most of the world's surface, but under the waves, one group thrives: fish. Here, we are the outsiders. Fish are masters of the waters. For some, the only way of avoiding danger is by hiding amongst their own kind, in shoals. Marine turtles have altered their front legs really radically and turned them into oar-like flippers. Reefs are the richest habitats on Earth. It's not surprising that with so many different kinds of animals living so closely together, some extraordinary relationships have evolved. A clownfish, a small and defenceless resident of the reef. From all over the reef, lobsters come to join the march. White tips.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to
move it.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to
move it.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to
move it.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to
move it.
All girls all over the world. Original King Julian for the girls, man. I love how all the girls, they love to move their body. When you move your body, you know, move it nice and sweet and sassy. All right? Woman, you're cute.